as per protocol, you see, there is a sort of protocol which is described. When a king moves, so many number of elephants have to go, so many number of horses have to go. For example, he says, Nava Naga Sahasrani, Yathavidhi, as per protocol, you see. That is 9,000, say, elephants, they are supposed to follow when the king follows, it seems. And then several chariots, all these number of, say, chariots and number of horsemen, etc., they are all mentioned here. So many chariots and so many archers and so many horsemen, all the people they just followed, and all the queens also followed. And when the queen, Valmiki is now saying, Kaikeyi cha Sumitra cha Kausalya cha Yashasvini. The first name mentioned is Kaikeyi. Kaikeyi, it is looking as though she is now leading all the queens. Kaikeyi is now repentant, you see. Kaikeyi, sometimes we feel actually sympathy for her. Kaikeyi, after all, she was interested in her son and she made a demand. And everybody is, he is falling foul on her and then everybody is criticizing. Now, Kaikeyi is a person who is repentant. And again, even in this situation, Bharata again is going to treat her in a very, very harsh way, as we see later. So, Kaikeyi is also coming, Kaikeyi, Sumitra and Kausalya, all the people, they all started. And all the respectable, all the respected persons, you see, Prayatascha Arya Sanghataha. Arya Sanghata means, Arya, I said, is a respectable person, all the noble persons, let us say. All the groups of all noblemen and all respectable elderly people, all those people, they all started Ramam Drashtum Salakshmanam in order to see Rama, they all moved. And here again, you see, Valmiki again describes various types of tradesmen, you see, all community leaders, you see, and Valmiki describes so many communities. Already the workers had gone, engineers and workers, they had all gone and then they had laid the roads. But now these people, they are all community leaders, you see. Manikarascha, Manikara means jewelers, you see. Then Kumbhakarascha, potters, potters means leader, some leaders among potters, leaders among Manikaras, and leaders among the Sutra Karma Visheshagnyaha. Then again, Mayurakaha, Mayurakaha means those who actually sell the feathers of peacocks, etc. Like this, all types of, in those days, all the types of, people. By whatever profession, by whatever trade they lived. For example, Dantakara. Dantakara means the people who take out the ivory and then make some toys with the ivory. Maybe ivory, say, combs, etc. All those people. And Shaundika. Shaundika means the people who prepare liquor. So, that probably that community was also there. And then Vaidya, doctors, etc. And then again, Shailushasya. This again is interesting. Shailusha means an actor. In those days, stage acting was there in India. You see, even in old India, we know that there is Bharata's Natya Shastra. Natya Shastra, we know that there are actors and actresses. Probably India is well known for actors and actresses and whatnot, like we now have our own Bollywood, Tollywood, and all types of woods. So, in those days also, all these Shailushaha actors were very prominent, it seems. Similarly, Vedavido, Brahmanaha, Vritta Sammataha, all the Veda Pandits, etc., they also started. All the people, several, the cross section of society, let us say, the whole cross section of society, they all started. And they all reached very, very slowly, they just travelled, because the path was already they made. And then Te Gatva Dura Madhvanam, they reached that place called Shrungiberapuram, where Rama also reached. Earlier, when Rama reached the Shrungiberapuram, and Shrungiberapuram is the place where that Guha also stays. So, they all reached that Shrungiberapuram, and Bharata tells ministers, okay, we will all camp here tonight. So, he camps there at that place. Then, we come to the next sarga, you see. In this next sarga, that is 84th sarga, we see Guha. We know that Guha is a person who has got mastery over the forest. He has got lot of tribesmen, and then you see, if you go into a forest, the villagers, forest village and the villagers, they know from a distance, even from 10 kilometers, they know as to who is moving in a radius of about 5 to 10 kilometers, the villagers, they know. That is what we see. If you go to a jungle, you see, maybe about 5 to 10 kilometers radius, whatever goes on, the villagers know. If at all somebody, some new person is coming, they come to know. So, Bharat, this Guha also, he knows, Nishadarajo Drushtaiva Jnatin Saparito Bravit. So, he saw that huge army coming. Bharata also does not see First of all, he doesn't see all the queens and all those, say, all the elderly people he doesn't see. But only the army is so visible, you see. The army is visible and Bharata is there in a nice chariot with his flag and whatnot, and all around him is the army. And maybe behind him are various chariots or bullock carts, etc., in which all these elderly people are sitting. So, that is the scene. So, he sees only this army and he feels, he feels rather apprehensive. There is such a mighty, he alerts all his associates, you see. That mighty army looked like an ocean. That is what, say, Valmiki writes. Mahatiyam sena sagarabha pradushyate. Sagarabha, sagarabha means it is almost like a ocean. It is looking like a ocean. And they say, yadanakalu durbuddhihi bharatasvayamagataha. This Bharata, is he a durbuddhi? Is he having an evil mind? Is he having an evil intention against Rama? He has come himself, you see. And why is he coming here? Is he trying to, say, capture us or attack us or do some harm to us, or has he come in order to harm Rama? So, that is what he is apprehensive about that. He says, is it to attack us or is it to attack Rama? And he says, we should not allow that to happen, because Rama, you see, Rama is a person who loves us all and Rama is our best friend. So, we have to support Rama and let us all get ready to resist if it is necessary. And he says, he orders all his men, go navam shatanam panchanam kaivartanam shatam shatam, you see, let us get ready about 500 boats. By that time, it means that Bharata, this Guha, was also a fairly strong person with so many boats and so many boatmen. Let 500 boats be made ready with about 100 people in each boat. So, that means so many soldiers were there. And all the people, they were all wearing armors, etc., they were all ready for any type of attack, etc. So, our archers, etc., they should all be ready, they should be wearing armors. So, Bharata, and he says, Bharata can cross Ganga only if he has got a pure mind. If he has got an evil mind or if he has got a bad intention towards Rama, he cannot cross. So, that is what he says.